Belshazzar gave a great banquet for thousands of his noble and drank wine with them. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I am a teacher of the word, but I don't read much of the word. The word is in me. I speak the word, I don't read the word. You will never find me reading the whole paragraph or the whole chapter. I will tell you the chapter. I'm just reading the word for the sake of those who don't read the Bible. So let me talk tonight. Let me talk tonight. You bless the Lord for the ministers that ministered from Thursday until yesterday. It was so awesome. It sounded better. It was so awesome. And God has done wonders. Praise the Lord. I want to ensure somebody on this last day that you will never regret for being here. If you have failed to get something for the past 3 days, make it an appointment that tonight you get something. I believe the Lord, when He gives me a word, there is a reason. I'm one of the preachers that don't speak according to what I think or what I've heard before, but I sit down and I listen to Him. That's why it takes time for me to tell you what I'm going to preach about until the last days. Yes. Where we just read, we were reading about a kingdom of Babylon. A kingdom of Babylon. Praise the Lord. The Bible says there was a king, Nebuchadnezzar, who was ruling in the kingdom. You know the story about King Nebuchadnezzar. The Bible says he used to take the people of God and make them captives. If you read the earlier chapters, you'll find that about Daniel, they were in captives in Babylon. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
This was a king that was against everything about God. You understand what I'm talking about? This was a king that was against everything that was about God. Reason, because he has his own gods that he was saving. That's why he didn't want to hear anything about the Almighty God or our God or the real God. You understand what I'm saying? Then the Bible says they were in captives, and times went, and it happens that God was angry to this king or to this nation of Babylon. He made a way that he showed up. Because God wants his anger showed up. God always shows up when he's angry. He makes sure that he shows up in this nation. Understand somebody that Babylon was not only the name of a country or the name of the city, but the word Babylon is one of the spirits, or is a certain kind of spirit. When we're talking about Babylon, we are talking about a certain spirit that rules in a place. We may be living in Johannesburg, but we are living in Babylon. You may be living in South Africa, but you are still in Babylon. Because Babylon is the spirit that rules, or the system that rules. The system that says we don't want to hear anything about the God of these people. Yeah. Then the Bible says the king went to the house of God, and he took some vessels of gold and silver. He took the vessels of gold and silver, and he put them in his own palace. He said, we, as a family of Babylon, we're going to utilize these vessels. The Bible says he visited Jerusalem, the house of God, to take vessels there. I wish you may be not living in Babylon. It's my prayer that you may not live in Babylon. It's my prayer that you may not live in Babylon. Now, it happened that God showed up to This king, Nebuchadnezzar, is the king that changed to be an animal. If you don't know exactly, do I say? God showed up and this man ended up being an animal at some point, and he was eating grass as a sign of curse. I'm so surprised if you can still eat grass in our days. What do you mean? The Bible says God showed up in many ways up until this man believes. Because God will not let you go unless you believe. Then the Bible says this man now changed the system. Says, I've seen the God of heavenly hosts, the real God. Meaning that the God that they were serving was not a real God. Because this man is confessing, I've seen a real God. The God of Israel. Now, when the Bible says, the son of this king, that's where my message is. The son of this king became a king. You understand? The Bible says he became a king. He actually took over to the kingdom. Took over to the kingdom. Now, when Belshazzar took over to the kingdom, he prepared a banquet. He made a party.
My God.
Then he said, there are vessels that our father took from the house of Israel. In this party, in this event, we are going to utilize them. I'm not sure how many vessels are utilized by the devil. He ate a fowl from the house of the Lord. I'm not sure how many people who are in the house of the Lord yet utilized by the devil. But in this night, the Bible says they went and take all the vessels that are from the house of the Lord and they drank wine with it. Allow me to announce my message. A man without limitation. A man without limitations. Then the Bible says they prepared a man without limitations. A man without limitations. I had to talk about a man without limitations. A man without limitation. I wish I had somebody who can understand what I'm trying. I wish when I preach, I need people to be in the spirit. Get the message before I give it to you. A man without limitation. Now, the Bible says it continued. The event continued. They give me some dancing song. Not the church one. I want to dance like the devil. One of those songs. Those songs.
It's closed, it's not closed, but a hand appeared.
door being closed. He was not limited by the wall. But what happened, the Bible says, they just saw a hand on the mirror. Right. Come on, somebody, tell your neighbor that the hand is about to run. The hand is about to run. The hand is about to write in my situation. The hand is about to write in my problems. The hand is about to write in my issues. The hand is about to write in the situation. The hand is about to write in the disease.
Jesus, in
Jesus. In the name of Jesus. A man without limitation. Now, when you go to the book of John 6, chapter 8, verse 6, the Bible says, they brought the woman and say, this woman was found in adultery. Yet we didn't know that there was a hand that wrote somewhere. He is making a mistake when he comes to you with your problems to Jesus. He is making a mistake when he reports your weakness to Jesus. He is making a mistake when he said you are a sinner to Jesus. You don't know. I don't care what the devil says, but there is a hand. And the Bible says, this guy has said, this woman, she deserved to die. She deserved to be stoned until then. I'm not sure what the devil has declared about your life, but there is a turnaround today. The hand is about to write a turnaround. The hand is about to write a turnaround. Come on, somebody say a turnaround. A turnaround. No matter what he has declared, but there is a turnaround. 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 In the next 5 years because of your disease. I don't care, but tonight is another night. Yeah. Maybe they told you that because of that HIV and AIDS, the cancer, it can never be prevented anymore. So you shall surely die. I do not care. There's one thing that God told me, that there is a hand. He is a God of no limitation. He is a God without limitation. He is about to rise. He is about to ride. He is about to ride. He is about to ride. In the name of Jesus. I want to close. When you continue with the chapter, ha, mighty Jesus. Shalabakati. Makune matuye kama Zekalibo sute Mandemiko libasea Urebe siko taya Makune masato Yenebo sute ma Makune mesika Ripa taya ma Yenebo masute Mulia masika Yeah. When you continue with it, one further, it says a man of God came to interpret. Receive the interpretation for you. He came to interpret. It says, once there were three words, four, but there were three. The first one repeated itself, and there was a reason. There was a reason why it came twice. The first one was many. Repeat it and say amen. Receive, say amen, amen. In other words, it says, I put a stamp, I keep a service. Yeah. Ah. Yeah. It's an emphasis. I'm emphasizing what I'm saying. Amen. It's like you didn't hear. Okay, man. Okay, you didn't hear very well. Man. In other words, what I'm saying, it is. This is what it means. Bible readers, what does it mean? And say, you king, you have played, like Basaran, the devil has played with us for many times. He has used us in many ways. Yeah. To be in poverty, you've been used by the devil. Yes. It's not the will of the Lord. Yes. To be in lake, you've been used by the devil. Yeah. It's not the will of the Lord. But God comes today to the devil and say, because of you, Zimak belongs to the church. Because of you, Zimak belongs to the house. Using a vessel. The Bible says, we are vessels of honor. We are vessels of honor. The devil cannot touch us and God not react because we are vessels of honor. Do you understand what I'm saying? We are vessels of honor. The Bible says, he said to him, amen, amen. Which means your days or the days of your kingdom has been made and numbered. And I've put it on a scale. I love my version, it says on a balance scale.
Jesus.
How many people know the balance scale?
Yes. Yeah.
God gave me a revelation here. When you want to weigh something on a scale, you don't put a scale on top of the thing, but you take the thing on top of the scale. If I want to take this couch on top of this to measure it on a scale, I'm not going to put a scale on top of it.
Yes.
I have to take the couch on the scale. But this is a heavy one. I can never take it up and put it on the scale. I will fail. I don't know if people understand what I'm saying. I cannot lift this thing and put it on the scale myself. Otherwise, I will need assistance. But God says to the kingdom of the devil, I've taken your kingdom by my hand and I've put your kingdom on the scale. I have measured it and I have found it that it is weak. I have found it that it has not had power. I have found it that it has... Come on! That situation is nothing. There is no situation bigger than my goal. There is no situation bigger than my goal. It is nothing. If you could take the kingdom, a kingdom, like using his hand, your situation, you don't need to use his hand. You can say, but can you hold an end, the small one? Can you hold it? The small one, the black one, too small. If you want to lift it, you can do this. On the table, you can't take it out. That's how our situation is. He don't need more power. He don't need to use anything else. He just said, poverty, failure. Yeah, it is. I'm doing my final year this year. Unfortunately, I didn't have a sponsor. So I had to go to the company that was sponsoring me for the past 4 years. I asked for a loan. They gave me a loan. My loan was approved. Yet some of the people, they didn't get a loan. It was the grace of God. In debt, I said, let me play low to tighten my chance, push a plan up. Let me play low to just put my documents for this one. I put my documents, I got approved. He said, we're giving you the loan. I was sitting here Friday. This man called me from this place, it's a nice place in Joburg. When you south side of the south gate of Joburg, what's that place? Sentin, yes. A lady from Sentin called me. Said, this is the number, how are you? Said, I'm good, thanks. At that time, I was a bit stressed. I was thinking my situation is bigger than my goal. He knows, I told him. I didn't have a way, I didn't have a plan. She knows. He knows as well. I didn't have a plan. She called me and said, I sent you an email. You check it. Take the email. The email it says, we want to sponsor you with 78,000 for your fees. You see, this is not a loan, it's a bazaar. I was like, that the situation I was saying is bigger than my goal. And she told me that go to the finance, ask them to give you your financial statement and bring us bank details.
Jesus.
I needed 60,000. I borrowed a loan for 50,000 from ESMA. And ESMA's gave me something about 70 something thousand in loan. And this lady now is saying, we're going to give you 70,000. All the loans, I'm going to cancel them. The Bible says, I shall know, I shall owe no man. But I was worried, how come I'm owing?